Picture this. What if your house and the roads could store energy just like batteries do? What if we can take cement and charcoal, mix them together to make this happen? What would you call that? I know the name, and it's super cool. A few years ago, I made a video where I took two solar panels, added a charge controller, and connect them to an array of supercapacitors that I bought on Amazon. This setup was used to run a small office fridge. The whole idea behind that experiment was to demonstrate how to use solar energy without battery, and especially during an emergency.
Les pido en este momento que se metan donde se tengan que meter. Aquí estamos corriendo vida o muerte.
El huracán María azotó a Puerto Rico, dejando a la isla desgarrada hasta la mitad.
I live in Puerto Rico, and back then we got hit by a Cat 5 hurricane, and it became very difficult and expensive to buy batteries. I did find a lot of suppliers online, but shipping batteries is very expensive, not to mention that the estimate wait was from 4 to 8 weeks to arrive. That is why I experimented with supercapacitors. Not only they got here in 2 weeks, they also came in via standard mail. The basic explanation of that setup is simple. If you have an item that you want to turn on using solar energy, you are going to need around twice the amount of energy you're going to use in solar panels. In the video, I use a small office fridge, like I said before, that needed around 200 watts. That is why I use 400 watts in solar panels. The reasoning behind the idea was, when the clouds got in between the sun and the solar panels, there was going to be enough energy going through the clouds over the solar charge controller to the supercapacitor, and the capacitor will have enough energy stored in them to keep the fridge on until the clouds move over. Now, why do I need supercapacitors if I have solar panels? You see, solar panels could go from 0 volts up to 24 volts. Some of them could go higher, but the voltage changes depending on what's going up in the sky, making it difficult to get a steady voltage to power whatever item you want. The supercapacitors are used to clean that voltage. If you want me to make a video explaining step by step how to do the whole setup, how to connect everything, how everything works in conjunction between the solar panel, charge controller, supercapacitor, you need to leave a comment in this video. And if we could go over 100 likes, I will make that video for you. Fast forward to 2023, a group of scientists ran a test where they mix cement and charcoal to make a really big capacitor. A combination of these two materials creates a conductive nanocomposite that forms a supercapacitor. Carbon black forms a network of wires within the cement which can absorb charged particles when submerged in an electrolyte. The supercapacitors can be used to build energy storage systems in various applications, including buildings and roadways. The use of common materials like cement makes this technology accessible and scalable. This technology could have huge implications not only for people in remote areas, but also for us that live in the Caribbean and we get hit by hurricanes quite a lot. It could also mean that we don't rely anymore on buying batteries. We can technically build them ourselves here locally. If you like this video, please leave a comment. Let me know what you think and what other topics you want me to explore, research, and make a video about. Also, leave a like, and don't forget, Jesus loves you, and God bless you. See you later. Bye.